Hey, my name is Ben. Thanks for stopping by. Today we're going to talk about the pros and cons of mini splits, and I'm going to tell you 5 reasons why they're awesome and 5 things that you have to be aware of, or the cons for a mini split air conditioner system. Now, to begin with, I just want you guys to know that I am an HVAC and refrigeration technician, and I've been working in this industry for over 10 years at this point. So I do have some experience with mini splits as well as your standard traditional systems. So let's go ahead and get started right away with the pros for a mini split. So number one, no ductwork is required, and that is so nice for a lot of situations where you have a finished house or a finished structure that you want to do minimal intrusive work to, basically. So if you have multiple rooms that you want to run air conditioning to without running ductwork, a mini split is a great way to go. You can see right behind me here, this is what we would call a line set, and that is the only thing that needs to run to each head unit. This is a head unit right here, and this hangs in whichever room you are going to be adding air conditioning to. And they have multi-zone mini splits as well as single zone mini splits, which the one right behind me here is a single zone mini split, and I'm going to be installing it in my garage right here. So that's reason number one, no ductwork required. Number two, minimal holes and building modifications. I kind of mentioned this already, but with existing structures that are already finished, you don't want to have to do too much as far as cutting big holes for ductwork, and so a mini split is going to mitigate that need. And it also is really beneficial where you have a concrete structure or a brick structure where, you know, in traditional framed homes like most houses are in the United States, cutting a hole isn't that big of a deal. But if you are going through 6 inches or 8 inches of concrete, that is much more difficult, which I think is one of the reasons why mini splits are super popular in other countries more than they are in the US. The third reason why mini splits are great is that they generally only require one electrical circuit coming from your panel. And it's typically going to be around a 30 amp circuit for that. It might even be less than that. It might even only be 20 amp depending on the size of your specific mini split. Now, that's different from a traditional system because a traditional system has both that 30 amp circuit typically, okay, that's not across the board, 30 amp, 240 volt circuit going to the outside unit, and then you also have to have your air handler inside of the building. So an air handler a lot of times is combined with a gas furnace. You have a gas furnace that has a blower in it, and that has to have a separate power supply. And so that is just more work, more complicated to have that second set of wires, that second piece of equipment that you have to run additional power to. With this indoor head unit, typically, I can't say across the board, but 90% of the time or more, this inside unit right here is powered directly from the outside unit, and you run a wire with your line set. Let me just show you the wire here quick. And this is what that wire looks like. It's a combination of communication cable and power cable for that head unit on the mini split. So only one circuit is required, so that's pretty convenient. You just run one circuit to the outside unit and then you're done. Fourth reason why mini splits are awesome is that it doesn't generally require a thermostat. You don't have to have a specific place where you have your thermostat wire pulled to in the house, in a hallway, like you would traditionally have with a regular system. Typically, they come with a remote controller like the one I'm holding right here, and this is the thermostat. So you can put this wherever you want to in the room that you're heating or cooling, and it is going to control that unit. So it just saves a lot of extra work for running that thermostat wire. Now, I know some mini splits do allow you to still run a thermostat wire, I believe, so that is still an option, but it's not required. And finally, the fifth reason why mini splits are awesome is that you can control the temperature in each room independently. So if I had another room off of this garage, or if I was putting a multi-zone mini split into my house, I could have a separate thermostat or remote control in each room. So if you have people that are sensitive to the temperature a little bit more, and one person wants the temperature to stay at 76 and the other person wants it to be 72, it's the perfect solution for that because you can control them independently. With a traditional ducted system, you can't do that. You have to just go with whatever the average kind of ends up being, and you can kind of help the temperature be balanced by scheduling your fan on your furnace and things like that, but it's still not quite as convenient as just having an individual thermostat in each room. Now, I'm sure there are more reasons why mini splits are awesome, but those are just the top five that I could think of off the top of my head. If you guys are looking towards purchasing a mini split, I am going to be installing this one right here behind me. It's by Cooper and Hunter specifically. I'll put links in the description to a few different model options and sizes that are available. So if you were thinking about getting a mini split anyway and you want to follow along with that, I'm going to be putting up several videos over the next few weeks that are going to be about installing a mini split, and we should cover pretty much the entire process going through that. So click on the links right in the description underneath this video. Like I said, I'll put a few different sizes and a few different configurations there for you guys to look at. They have whole packages that are available that include all the accessories that you can see right here. So you can get a complete kit that has virtually everything that you'll need, with the exception of the wires that actually go out to the mini split. But other than that, you can get pretty much the whole kit from Cooper and Hunter. So again, links in the description right underneath this video, and you can check out the different systems that are available from Cooper and Hunter. Okay, so those were the pros. Now let's talk about the cons, or the negative things, in my opinion, about mini splits that are just things that you have to be aware of when you go to purchase a mini split. So the first one is going to be, maintenance is generally more complex and expensive. Now, this is anecdotally, this is in my opinion, but having worked on quite a few mini splits, when I do have to work on them, it just seems like the process is not as easy. And a lot of that does come down to experience and like the number of systems that are out there. So on average in our area, the majority of systems are gonna be traditional ducted systems, a regular air conditioner and air handler in the house. And I know those things inside and out and can fix them fast and efficiently. So when I go to service a mini split, generally, they're just a little bit more complicated and they work slightly differently from each other. So a lot of times you're spending more time in the manual, you're spending more time with tech support depending on the situations. So generally speaking, they just seem to be a little bit harder to maintain and a little bit more difficult to fix if and when something does go wrong. The second thing is that, anecdotally again, in my experience, they don't last quite as long as traditional systems. The way they're built and the quality of them doesn't seem to be quite as nice as a traditional forced air ducted system. So the way these things are constructed is good enough and they look nice, but this is all kind of just thin plastic, especially the unit that hangs on the wall, and I've seen plastic housings crack and just general quality issues with them, but it should last you a good 10 years minimum. But what we tell people for a traditional air conditioner is that we'd like to see you get 20 years. And maybe on average, people do get 20 years out of them. I can't speak to that for sure. That's just my opinion. If I was installing this and I was doing the math calculation on the cost benefit of the unit, I would calculate it based on 10 or 15 years, not 20 or 25 years for sure. The third con is that they are expensive. And they might be similarly priced to a traditional system. Now, talking more about the cost of materials here, not installed. If you're gonna have to install ductwork, that's obviously an upfront cost that is significant. But if you're talking about a house that already has ductwork, and you're thinking about replacing the air conditioner or adding a mini split, the cost is gonna be similar, and sometimes the mini split's gonna be even more money installed than a traditional system. And if you have ductwork in your house and the ductwork is good, I would recommend putting in a new standard system and not a mini split. So just keep that in mind, especially with the fact that a mini split probably isn't gonna last quite as long as a traditional system. Paying almost the same money or more money for a mini split doesn't make sense if you have ductwork already. Reason number four is that, generally speaking, domestic units are not available for mini split systems. Now, if you guys know of any made in the USA mini splits, let me know and comment down underneath this video, and also comment any other thoughts that you have about this whole topic in general and your experiences with mini splits, if you really like them or if you really dislike them. But I haven't been able to find units that are made in the USA that are mini splits, and almost all of them are made in Asia. So with most mini splits being non-domestically manufactured, the parts are not as standard. With a regular air conditioner, we carry almost all the parts for most air conditioners are on the truck, with the contactors, the capacitors, and if we need parts, they're like usually less than one day away. And some mini split manufacturers are also like that, where you can get the parts relatively soon, but condenser fan motors and the motors and things that are inside of these units are not standard equipment for us to carry on our trucks. So if you have your mini split go down and you have a service company come out, it's most likely gonna take them a little bit longer to fix it, going back to that cost thing again. They're gonna probably have to make a return trip with the special order parts. Now, not all of the parts are non-standard. They do have capacitors that are regular capacitors and things like that. But generally, since they're not domestic, it is a little bit more difficult to get parts. Again, let me know if you guys know of any made in the USA products or for mini splits, but most of them, even from like American manufacturers like Carrier, are just rebranded units that are purchased from other companies overseas. And finally, reason number five is cosmetically, when you install a mini split unit, you have a couple of things that change on the structure. The first being you have a visible line set. This pipe right behind me here is going to run up the wall on the building somewhere on the outside. And you can get cover kits and things like that, and I'll link those in the description. But just adding that, it almost looks like a downspout if you put that trim kit on there. And it doesn't look horrible, but it's an added thing on the outside of your building. The other thing cosmetically that you have to think about is, what do you want the unit to look like in the room? Because typically ductwork is concealed, and you'll have either a vent on the ceiling, just like a minimal vent, or a vent coming through the floor like a rectangular vent. With this, obviously, that's a pretty significant item to be hanging on the wall. So you just have to know how that's gonna change the room aesthetically. They do have some pretty cool systems now that have alternate ways of basically getting the cooling into the room. So they have, I think they're called cassette units, one that goes like in the ceiling. So you almost can't even tell that it's a mini split. So I'll link to those in the description underneath this video as well. But you just have to think about those things when you're considering a mini split. So after all that, who should really buy a mini split? If I were to summarize it, as best I can, it would be people who want to save space, who don't want to run ductwork, and who want independent temperature control potentially in multiple zones. Those are kind of the two main reasons. So in my garage here, I am going with a mini split because it's gonna take up no floor space whatsoever. My garage is pretty small. This garage is 24 feet by 22 feet. So it's small enough to where every square foot counts. So if I had to set a furnace on the floor and run ductwork in here, it would take up a decent portion of the building, which I really would like not to do. The other thing that's pretty cool about almost all mini splits is that they are all set up as heat pumps. And that means that you can use them for some heating as well as the cooling. And Cooper and Hunter claims that you can actually heat with this thing down to pretty cold temperatures, like even sub-zero, this thing can still crank out some heat. So potentially a mini split can handle the full cooling and heating loads of your building, which is pretty nice. So you basically have your furnace and your air conditioner all in one, and it's all electric on that one single circuit like we talked about earlier. So my plan with this particular unit is I'm gonna give this thing a run for its money. We're gonna put this in my garage as the exclusive heat source. I might install a little ventless propane heater over here as backup just in case, but I'm gonna let this thing do the heating this upcoming winter here in Minnesota. So if you guys want to see how that turns out, then definitely subscribe to the channel, and I'll be making ongoing videos about this system and about other mini split systems going forward. So if you guys are thinking about purchasing a mini split. Again, links right underneath this video, and you guys can look at the different options that are available from Cooper and Hunter. And if you're going to be installing one anyway, it's perfect timing because I'm also doing it and we're going to be going through that whole process together. We'll talk more about mini splits in an upcoming video very soon. If you guys already happen to be installing your mini splits, then I do have one video about how to do a proper mini split flare for R410A systems. So go ahead and click on that video right down here, and I'll see you over there in just a few seconds. Or you can click on this video up here, and that's the video that YouTube thinks that you would like to watch.